The title of my talk today is on motion segmentation and tracking. So today I'll be dealing with different elements of motion analysis and introduction to motion segmentation and a little bit of visual tracking. Okay, first an introduction to this basic topic of motion segmentation. I'll illustrate this with the help of an example. Let's see this particular video here, full screen. Yeah. So, this is a video taken with some pretty old surveillance cameras at the University of Maryland College Park, and you can see two people who are loitering about aimlessly here, one of whom you may recognize, especially the one, the tall 6 foot guy in the blue shirt, right? Okay. Now, given this video, the task at hand is to automatically segment out the one particular object, let us say it is this black SUV here. Okay. The problem is basically we have to segment out this particular black SUV on the basis of motion information. We have to do this particular task of motion analysis and motion estimation automatically, and after that we can do some rather interesting things with it. We can do things like with this particular object, we can remove it. We can remove it automatically from the frames of the video, right? Remove it, and also we might like to do something naughty with it. We might want to paste something over this parking lot. So, the initial part of my lecture today will deal with some techniques that will enable us to do so automatically. That is, in a nutshell, corresponding to this black vehicle, we would want to identify the pixels that are moving. After that, we would want to remove the object of interest, which is this black SUV out here. We would want to remove it from this video automatically, not manually frame by frame. And after that, at the end, we would want to paste an image onto this parking lot box. Just a little bit of introduction, little bit of theory. There are two things. Physics says that one looks at a motion field. Okay, a motion field is the actual physical process wherein we identify an element of motion with each pixel, all right, because of the relative motion between the object and the camera. And optic flow or optical flow is something that is observable, all right, and that in general would correspond to the motion field. The motion field is the physical entity, or uska jo impact hai, uska impact comes in terms of optic flow. In general, the optic flow is generally assumed to correspond to the motion field, apart from a couple of pathological cases. For instance, there could be a motion field but need not result in optic flow. One particular example of this is, for example, a rotating sphere of a uniform color and texture. So, if this sphere is rotating, there is a motion field, physically there is motion, but there is no impact on the image. Image mein kuch pata nahi chalta, okay, that does not correspond to optic flow. And further, there could be no motion field, but there could be optic flow. For instance, there could be a very shiny sphere and a source of light moving all around that shiny sphere. Usme koi motion field nahi hai, the object is not moving, lekin it results in optic flow, or maybe the same sphere. All right, but in general in motion analysis, what we assume is that motion field corresponds to optic flow. All right. Now, in motion analysis, we specifically use simple 2D motion models. Okay, a very valid question is 2D hi kyon, why not 3D? Okay. Now, the reasons for this are the following. 3D motion computation involves optimization over quite a few variables, and as you would have also worked on this, finding out the variables is generally a process of nonlinear optimization. I believe your group here uses quite a lot of AI based techniques. Multi-objective optimization, you use, I think, bacteria foraging and a couple of rather interesting algorithms for this. So, it is not too easy. Even the 2D case is not too easy. The 3D case involves estimating more parameters. So, it is obviously much more difficult. Well, 2D, the advantage is, yes, less variables. This is numerically stable. Numerical analysis is, it is not a science, it is an art. It is in fact a black art, okay, because there are lots of knobs to tune. And accordingly, that gives you the optimization. Plus, we have an overdetermined system. It always helps to solve problems in the least squares sense, right? Okay. Now let's motivate the problem as follows. Suppose this is a frame in a video at time t, and here, note carefully, this is the frame at time t plus 1. Okay. ये देखिए. So normally क्या होता है, हम ऐसा assume करते हैं कि our sampling rate is actually very high. Temporal rate of sampling is actually quite high, so that two frames will not be too different from each other. This is an important assumption that is often used, because otherwise these problems are generally intractable. One generally has to put in some constraints in order to operate on that. Isme the main important thing that one uses in any motion segmentation problem is the brightness constancy assumption. Iska kya matlab hai? If I is a function, right? So here this is a function of x, y and t, that is a pixel in a video. A video can be taken to be a box, right? Jisme ki aise aise kaafi frames hai aur har frame mein x or y coordinates hai. So here, so the image brightness at a point x plus p, y plus q and at t plus 1 should correspond to the corresponding pixel in the image at point x comma y and at time t. हम यही कह रहे हैं कि दो frames हैं, एक time t पे है और एक time t plus 1 पे है, तो जो point time t पे xy position पे था, वही point हटके t plus 1 में x plus p, y plus q उस वाले point पे आ रहा है. Is this point clear to everybody? Right? So this is a reasonable assumption. यही कह रहे हैं कि a particular object does not change its brightness or color drastically. कई बार ऐसे हो सकता है, right? Psychedelic lighting or जैसे person walking under the trees, कभी धूप कहीं छाओ, उस type का scenario. कभी कभी हो जाता है, लेकिन in general, this is a reasonably tenable assumption. Okay, what do? Mathematically, whenever we see such an expression. So mathematicians' eyes generally light up in such a scenario, or what one applies is generally a Taylor series approximation. So it's easier to apply a first order Taylor series approximation, right? First order Taylor series expansion mein jo change hua hai, either right hand side mein without the change likhte hain, plus p into the derivative of the image with regard to x, jitne bhi variables hain, essentially wo derivatives likhte hain, the change in x into the derivative of the image with regard to x, q which is the change in y direction mein kitna hila hai in terms of pixels, into the derivative of the image with regard to y, plus time mein kitna change hua hai, which is exactly one frame, 1 into the derivative with respect to time, that is it. Now what are these quantities? Acha isko agar compare kare aur fir wo upar jo brightness constancy assumption hai usko lagate hain, I cancel out these two terms, all right? So the result of which is the following equation. This is also called the classic Horn and Schunck equation for optic flow. This generally is the starting point for any motion based algorithm, jisme bhi motion estimate karna chahte hain hum. All right, now let's also have a look at how does one compute this? What is it in terms of computation? In terms of computation, see, this should be an ideal equation, ideally, right? Now p and q need not be constants, they can also be functions. They can be functions of x and y, and worse still, they can also be functions of t. Now depending on the parametric motion model that we put here, we will put restrictions on p, q, okay, and then try to solve for them. Essentially our idea is to motion estimation means find the motion, ki kitna hila hai, p comma q, essentially x direction mein kitna hila hai point, or y direction mein kitna hila hai. That's our basic problem in motion estimation. Now we also need to get the physical significance of these terms. What is ix? That is the partial derivative of the image taken as a two-dimensional signal with regard to the x direction. What is that? It's a simple edge detector. Okay, just simply apply an edge detector in the image with respect to x. Okay, this can be as simple as a finite difference in the x direction. Okay, what is iy? This does differentiation of the image or finds out vertical edges, okay, finds out edges in the y direction. And what is it? It is the temporal derivative, essentially you can approximate that as a difference in time, that is frame t plus 1 minus frame t, that's all. Okay, so these quantities are easy to compute and also easy to compute fast. you can do it pretty fast, because these are all order n operations. Okay, these are linear time operations, they can be done rather fast. So in the discrete case, continuous case mein p ix plus q iy plus it would be equal to 0 ideally. Theek hai, agar continuous aise variables mil jaye, lekin discrete case mein typically we put it in the form of an optimization problem, because this could be a small quantity. In the discrete case, small quantity positive ho sakta hai, negative ho sakta hai. So to get rid of that, we put a square, and we would want to minimize the sum of squares. Okay, a minimization of a squared error over a region corresponding to the object of interest. Okay, now this actually raises a chicken and egg problem. Agar hame motion estimation agar hamara accurate hai, agar hum bata pate hain ki motion kya hai, usko accurately estimate kar paaye, then we know the object of interest. Apne aap pata chalega ki kya object of interest hai. And on the other hand, if you know the object of interest, it's easier to estimate the motion. Why? Because there could be more than one moving object in the image, right? Each with its own motion. Har ek ka motion estimate karna hai. Agar hame malum hai ki kaun se object ka motion estimate karna hai, if we know that these are the pixels we have to examine, so the motion estimation problem becomes easier. So we have a chicken and egg problem. Ek cheez mein agar thodi aasani hai to dusra solve ho jata hai, but then we don't. So that this is the difficulty of the problem. Now, one of the simplest models for this is what happens if p and q are constants. Okay, constants means this is a simple translation, right? Ek particular pixel translates in x and y. All right, if it's a pure translation, if this is a constant, then you get a translational model. And what you have to solve after this is a partial derivative of this error function with regard to the two variables tx and ty, solve them equal to 0. Two variables hain, p and q, two equations hain. P and q or tx and ty, two equations hain. You can do this. So if we do this for all pixels in this region and also put it into a matrix form, right? Kaise karte hain? It's a simple partial derivative iska. That's all. Just put it equal to 0. You get two equations and this is what you get. This is rather simple. Ye kisi bhi kitab mein mil jayega. This is essentially, this comes from the 1980 or 81, I think, AI paper by Horn and Shank. That is almost the starting point for motion estimation. Okay. And yeah, this is essentially what I said. This is a chicken and egg problem. Agar hame region of interest malum hai, we can estimate the motion. For instance, jo video dikhaya tha, agar hame malum hai ki is wale region mein wo black SUV hai, right, jisko segment out karna hai, then the problem becomes easier. But however, we do not know this automatically, because you have two people, okay, who are also loitering about in the scene aimlessly. Unka kya karein? Right, so motion segmentation works as follows. This is one, this was there in a 1994 paper in the International Journal of Computer Vision. This is the work of Mikhail Irani, Benny Russo and Shmuel Peleg. Okay, this is what I am describing here. First step is find the dominant translation using a pyramidal approach. Now, normally even in signal processing problems, this technique is sometimes used. Okay, looking at a signal across scales. Wilsky ka kaam hai isme, fir kaafi logon ka kaam hai. This is a pyramidal approach. So essentially one looks at an image at different scales. So one looks at scaled versions. Jaise ek bada image hai pure resolution mein, one looks at an image at half the resolution, uska half and so on. This helps, a hierarchical thing helps. After that, we segment it out, jo dominant translation hai. So if we have a chicken and egg problem, you need some point to approach it, jo chakravyuh hai, usko usme andar jane ke liye koi na koi tarika hona chahiye. We have to start at a particular point, right? So we start using this, finding the dominant translation. This is easy and computationally simple. The first step is segmenting it out, possibly using sequential labeling or any other method of segmentation. Uske baad, we apply a higher order motion model to the segmented region, not to the entire image. Pure image mein se sabse pehle hum dominant translation nikalte hain, uske baad higher order usko segment out karte hain aur fir usko refine karte hain step wise. Okay, we apply a higher order motion model. Jaise is case mein this was just translation. You could apply a affine motion model also, you could apply a projective motion model also, you could do lots of things with it. And we repeat the above till convergence till a particular error criterion has been met. Acha, or multi resolution framework kyun? The idea is as follows. We start at the lowest level, right? Least resolution level. We estimate the motion parameters according to whatever motion model we have, let's say translation. Theek hai, motion parameters estimate kiye. After that we register the two images, let's say signal hai. ठीक है, सिग्नल सबसे कम रेजोल्यूशन में है. ओके, वहां से हमने कितना हटा है कोई सिग्नल पॉइंट, वो एस्टिमेट किया है. उसके बाद वी रजिस्टर्ड द टू इमेजेस, यानी हायर लेवल पे वी एस्टैब्लिश अ कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंस कि ये अगर दो पिक्सल यहां पे होता तो इस वाले सिग्नल में कितने पिक्सल्स होते, मे बी चार पिक्सल होता, राइट? सो यू हैव अ मोर एक्यूरेट. सो वी इटरेट ओवर द टू इमेजेस, वी इंटरपोलेट द मोशन पैरामीटर्स to the next resolution level and refine this using higher resolution images. So lowest level se hum highest level tak jaate, right? And what these people propose is two functions. One is called the motion measure, okay, which is a measure of the amount of motion at a particular pixel. So brighter means more motion there, okay. They propose this, which is slightly noisy. This is exactly why optic flow is said to be noisy, okay. It's not that reliable. And additionally, okay, this is for example the dominant moving object, and there is another measure which they call as a sort of a ki kitna confidence hai in that particular motion. Okay, so this is just a little bit of math. This is one of the functions that the authors propose here. This is what they call a motion measure. Well, just look at it, and physically this is exactly it, ki it is a temporal derivative over a particular region. It's essentially a temporal derivative, all right, and which is tuned with some part of a spatial derivative. Spatial derivative because why? Because the image could be a low contrast image. Agar do low contrast images, do frames aise dekhen, to un dono ka difference utna zyada aayega nahi. Let's say it's been taken in the dark, evening mein liya gaya hai, to zyada to farak nahi hoga usme as compared to two images that were taken in a brightly lit environment. So you need to normalize by something like this, and this of course is for numerical stability. Hum denominator ko kabhi zyada chota nahi hone denge, warna the function will explode, right? Small denominator. And the second thing here is what the authors propose is a reliability measure. Okay, aapko ye wala matrix to ye to aapne dekha hoga na pichle wale slide mein. It's essentially this. So reliability they find as the ratio of the minimum eigenvector to the maximum eigenvector corresponding to this. This people would know as the inverse of the condition number of a matrix. Okay, right? And we take a decision. A pixel is stationary if its motion measure is low and the reliability of the motion measure is high, and a pixel is moving if the motion measure is high and the reliability also should be high. So you can see that ye thodi jaldi mein maine prepare kiya hai, so there is an error here. Enough of math. What we will be in all waiting for is results. Ye videos hai. Full screen kar dete. See, there are errors. Ye maine ek assignment mein diya tha. So the idea was to estimate the motion. Chaliye wapas jab ye aata hai fir dekhte hain. There could be errors in the motion estimation because there could be pixels which, dekhiye. Apparently this is a constant, most of the road should be of constant intensity, lekin thoda variation ho raha hai. This was a very old surveillance camera at the University of Maryland College Park jisse ye surveillance video liya gaya hai, but you'll see that in majority of the cases the motion estimation is reasonably good. Is case mein for instance it identifies the dominant motion wrongly, beech mein it got to those two loafers out there, okay, but then again it picked up. This is another attempt at segmentation. Essentially, ये मैंने assignment में दिया था, so I asked people to choose their parameters accordingly in terms of the region, in terms of the motion model, कितने levels पे hierarchically देखेंगे image को. So all of these, I told them, you tune your parameters. So these are just a couple of assignments. इसमें भी देखिए, it's possible to do this motion segmentation rather in a rather robust manner and also rather fast. Okay, ye 1994 ka paper hai, and what they claimed was that this could be done in close to real time, and you can see this is not a very easy segmentation case, kyunki ye fir wo pedon ki chhaon mein bhi जा रहा है, वो गाड़ी वहाँ पे भी जा रही है. ओके, सो इट्स पॉसिबल टू डू दैट सेगमेंटेशन रीजनेबली रिलायबली. ओके, नाउ इफ यू कैन सेगमेंट आउट द मूविंग ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, दिस इज अ स्टेशनरी कैमरा, दिस इज अ स्टेशनरी सर्वेलेंस कैमरा, राइट? वॉट कैन यू डू? अगर आइडेंटिफाई किया है कि ऑब्जेक्ट यहाँ पे है, जब ऑब्जेक्ट हट गया है, यू कैन पेस्ट बैक द ओरिजिनल पिक्सल्स व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट हैज मूव्ड आउट इनटू द फ्रेम्स. यू गेट द पॉइंट? ये देखिए, जैसे ये वाला एग्जाम्पल है, इसमें हमने आइडेंटिफाई किया है कि मूविंग पिक्सल्स को व्हाइट से ड्रॉ किया है, ठीक है? अब ये यहाँ से हट गया है, अब ये यहाँ से हटा है, तो अगर जो उनसे पिक्सल्स व्हाइट में मार्क हो गए थे, अगर ओरिजिनल पिक्सल्स यहाँ से पिकअप करें और फिर वहीं उन फ्रेम्स पे पेस्ट करें जहाँ पे वो व्हाइट पिक्सल्स थे, वी विल एसेंशियली गेट अ वीडियो विथ द ऑब्जेक्ट रिमूव्ड, एंड बिलीव मी द इफेक्ट इज रादर इंटरेस्टिंग. ये देखिए, दिस इज वन पर्टिकुलर अटेम्प्ट, इसको फुल स्क्रीन कर देते हैं. यू विल सी सम एरर्स, यू माइट सी सम एरर्स, जैसे यहाँ पे दिख रहा है, बट द इफेक्ट इज रादर इंटरेस्टिंग. हट गया है, इट्स एज इफ दैट ब्लैक एसयूवी वाज नॉट देयर एट ऑल. ओके, हमने ऑटोमेटिकली इसको हटाया है, हमने हर फ्रेम में कोई ह्यूरिस्टिक नहीं लगाया है, या फिर हर फ्रेम में मैनुअली इसको हटाया नहीं है. इट्स बीन डन ऑटोमेटिकली. दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट टू एम्फसाइज. या बिकॉज राइट नाउ दिस व्हीकल शुड बी बैकिंग आउट, राइट? और यहाँ पे यू कैन सी अ बिट ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्शंस. ओके, सो दिस इज नॉट, वेल, दिस फिजिकल प्रोसेस इज नॉट परफेक्ट, ऑलराइट, बट यू कैन एक्चुअली डू अ लॉट. एंड आजकल द अमाउंट ऑफ स्पेशल इफेक्ट्स दैट आर बीइंग यूज्ड इन मूवीज, lots of image processing, computer graphics, computer vision techniques are being used in movies, all right, and we've all seen them, kafi movies mein dekha hai, okay, both Hollywood movies as well as in India. Maybe we'll talk about a couple of special effects in movies. Have you seen the movie Pearl Harbor? It's a Ben Affleck movie. Agar aapne Pearl Harbor dekha hai, okay, that scene where all of these B-26 bombers take off from that aircraft carrier. In reality, there wasn't a single airplane on that deck. It was basically a model that was duplicated all throughout, or in most cases, it was actually a model that was taking off. Model means a graphical model, jisko image-based rendering technique se banaya gaya hai. Further, if you've seen the movie AI, that was a complete flop by Spielberg. But that had some rather interesting things, wherein a person is walking and you can see through his face. In that case, tracking was done, tracking of points on the face, visual tracking. Main tracking ka bhi thoda zikr karunga. And after that, some of these motion removal techniques were used. Hollow Man to aapne kai logon ne dekha hoga. Usme actually things were done a bit manually, wherein the person, those particular pixels were painted with green. और द पर्सन वॉज वेयरिंग समथिंग ग्रीन, और फिर जो ग्रीन पिक्सल्स थे उनको हटाया गया था फ्रॉम द फ्रेम्स. क्लोजर टू होम, शिवाजी, दिस इज अ तमिल ब्लॉकबस्टर. हैज एनीबडी सीन शिवाजी? ओके, या आई सॉ इट अ कपल ऑफ डेज बैक. उसमें फॉर इंस्टेंस हीरो रजनीकांत हैज बीन शोन एज अ फेयर मैन. ओके, उसमें ऐसे ही किया था, बेसिकली अ मैपिंग वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड टू a fair person and the skin colored pixels were removed. You can actually check for a couple of errors. Agar aap bahut dhyan se dekhen, there are some errors in Rajani's face, for instance, like, and the overall effect isn't too bad. So image processing techniques are used widely in movies, okay, not just in Hollywood, here also. Isme dekhiye, kuch aise artifacts dikhenge aapko, but the overall effect, this is actually a very simple algorithm. Yahan pe bhi thode artifacts aapko dikhenge. Okay, as if a ghost is moving about. But the main point is, we have been able to do this automatically. Automatically humne isko segment out kiya hai. And all of these are 90s developments. We'll be a bit naughty and we'll paste an image on the parking box. Kaise aayega? Haan, theek hai. Isko dekhiye. How about that? So an advertiser could basically put in an advertisement out here. So all of these are interesting interesting applications of one algorithm. Aapke paas algorithm hai haath mein, right? You can just apply your imagination and do things, whatever you want to do with this. Isme motion estimate kiya hai, un pixels ko replace karaya hai, aur phir har frame mein ye wala box paste kar diya gaya hai. Look at this for example. So you can see that the motion segmentation is reasonably good. Okay. So see, techniques like this can be used in movies as well and have been used. Okay, in movies there is generally not much scope for error. There would be an artist who would be doing some fine touch-ups. But otherwise, mote taur pe, these sort of techniques work rather well.